Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to Risk of Rain 2. I wanted to do a follow-up video here for the Loader just because, first off, I've been loving playing the Loader. And secondly, because I think that she deserves a second look here since I have a lot more hours. And I mean, like, probably I'd say 7 to 8 more hours of experience playing as the Loader in Risk of Rain 2 since that first impressions video went live earlier last week. Thank you, everybody, for the continued excitement and support for the return of the Risk of Rain 2 videos. Now, I'm not going to say that the series is totally back yet, but I will say that I've been having a blast playing Risk of Rain 2, and it's been a real treat being able to experience a new class with you all here, as the Loader is not even a month old yet. So I just want to give a follow-up on basically my overall thoughts on her, and hopefully we get ourselves a decent run to go along with this. And I'll just give you like a couple of items that I say that you want to keep a lookout for if you do decide to play as her, and just overall recommendations for her. So the Loader, of course, is the momentum-based class that is unlike anything else that you ever see in Risk of Rain 2. She is a predominantly... the game wants to make you believe that she's melee, but honestly, she plays a little bit more like a ranged character. If not a ranged character, then definitely a specialty character where you don't really use her basic attack for much of anything. While you can, of course, use her claw or her fist ability, that's not the one that you're going to be using for a majority of the time that you play as her. Most of the time, you're going to be using the charge fist ability, which, of course, is her... That's really where all of her damage comes from and originates and it revolves around, is movement speed. So there's a number of items in the game that you will find. Of course, anything that augments your movement speed is going to be king. Don't rely on the barrier, on the automatic barrier that you get from her passive. I think that it's really overvalued, and I definitely overvalued it. It was kind of an anomaly of a run with that first impressions because obviously I had 14 attack speed syringes, so that's a little bit of an unorthodox. You're not going to see that much attack speed on every single run, of course. So I take that into factor of what it was, which is just a really good attack speed run, but it's not realistic. Most of the time, the barrier is not going to make that much difference, and you shouldn't really, in my opinion, be using your basic attack as your overall main source of damage anyway. You're really going to be using the huge burst damage that you get from her charged fist ability, especially when you're moving super duper fast. So anything that augments her movement speed is going to be priority number one. Getting like energy drink, getting something like, say, the goat hoof, or even wax quail is quite good as well. Take another hop-up feather. Now, there's some other items that aren't necessarily movement-augmenting abilities, but are still pretty darn good, in my opinion. I think that Tougher Times is actually one of the more important ones that you can get for the Loader, because of the fact that you are going to be pretty much up close and personal to some of the fights that you experience throughout an entire run, but not always. You're mostly going to be attacking from afar and just kind of, you know, jetting your way in, doing tons and tons of damage, and then getting out. The Pylon, of course, I think that the Pylon is good, but it's not really... The only time I ever find myself using the Pylon nowadays is if I'm in an area that is completely devoid. Let me take a little bit of attack speed here. Even though Focus Crystal is a pretty important one to get for the Loader, because you are going to be dealing area damage while you're going through. It just helps you clear the smaller mobs. But generally speaking, I don't really use the Lightning Pylon for anything other than just dealing with like small enemies like Wisps or Beetles or that sort of thing. Anything that's in the air is usually what I use it for. The only time that I ever bring out the Lightning Pylon for movement is if I'm in an area that has like very pretty much nothing to grab on, like kind of like right now. So another item that's extremely important for the Loader that I found over the course of my 8 hours or so-ish experience with her is the extra magazine. I think the extra mag might be the most important non-movement speed augmenting ability that you can get, or not ability, but artifact that you can get. Being able to throw out multiple grapple hooks is pretty amazing, and it also completely changes the way of how she works. Like right now, I don't have a whole lot to grab onto, so I use the swing, and then we'll just jut forward here, and then use our hop-up feather. Ooh, there's a large chest. I would have never even seen this large chest. And it has another Old War stealth kit. The stealth kit's still pretty good. It's not what I would consider top tier or like top priority for her, but it's still quite good. If you take heavy damage, turning you invisible for a couple seconds is good enough for you to get away. Also, you have to keep in mind that the Old War stealth kit also increases your movement speed, which is important for the Loader, as we've already discussed. Let the Lightning Pylon deal with that. She's just a lot of fun. I would not really recommend her for a newer player. If you're not, if you're just starting out with Risk of Rain 2, don't even worry about playing as a loader. She's more of like a, one of those niche classes. I don't think that she's top tier. I think that the Huntress is still number one, in my opinion, as far as overall best character in the game. But it's hard to argue with the amount of fun that you can have as the loader. And I gotta say, because I've been having so much fun, I've been really motivated to play more Risk of Rain 2, which is good. It's good for everybody. It's good for the channel, good for me, and good for anyone who enjoys watching Risk of Rain 2 here as well in the mosh pit. Now, of course, I'm not going to say that the series is totally back, as I talked about earlier in this video, but I've been enjoying it. It's been a lot of fun. Being able to play and experience a new character with you all, that's relatively brand new, and still learn out the figure out the finer nuances and stuff of the class is really interesting. Oh, we have the Grove Tender. Well, the Grove Tender, this is just a side note from the loader here. The Grove Tender is a new boss for me. I have fought it 3 times. This is actually my 3rd time that I'll be fighting it, and it's a pretty formidable opponent. It does like a huge like chain, like it does like this weird chain attack. Hopefully we don't have to see it. Now, I'm going to fling myself off the map here, but we don't actually take damage from that because obviously with the loader's passive, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to Spider-Man my way over here again. Right at the last second there, the Royal Capacitor targeted the wrong thing. That's all right. Yeah, so that's what I'm kind of talking about, that one. So I'm trying to hold on. I'm trying to hold the grapple to the Grove Tender, but I'm moving at such force that it's actually breaking, and it's not actually repelling me back. Toss out the pylon here just because. There's the chains. There goes the Grove Tender. Get one more dunk as we're going off the edge. You gotta love the Royal Capacitor, man. Apparently there's a clay... Or at least there was a Clay Lemurian over here. Clay Lemurians are the giant Gatling gun dudes. I can't wait to see what other movement speed ability, augmenting abilities that we can get in the game that will make the loader even better. Now, as far as like playing in groups as a loader, she can definitely benefit a group a whole lot. If you need someone who isn't the Artificer to go in and deal some ranged burst damage, but you don't necessarily want to have to worry about their survivability, get yourself a loader player. I've seen better loader players than I, of course, do tons of damage, and it is absolutely insane watching them just fling themselves all around the map and stuff. It's a lot of fun. It truly is a spectacle sport class. And I think that truly highlights the best part of the class by far, which is just the amount of fun that you can have with her. But even though this might not be the best run to show off as a follow up, because we don't really have that many great items here, I just wanted to give my overall thoughts on the loader and Risk of Rain as a whole. I do have a soft spot for anything that looks somewhat melee, and of course she is somewhat melee, I guess. You could argue that she's a hybrid class. I think that's probably the best way to describe her, as a hybrid class. She's not exactly range, but she's not exactly melee either. I wouldn't say that she's a spellcaster. Oh, we have Magma Worm again. She was not a spellcaster necessarily, but it's hard for me to call her a primarily focused melee oriented character. She does hit stuff with her fist, but that's not because of that's not her main draw. That's not her main source of damage. She only hits it in the sense that like she hits it with her fist, but she's not up there brawling with stuff. Charge up the Royal Capacitor here. Take care of that brass contraption, and then we go for Mr. Magma Worm. The one rule that I will say is a golden rule for the loader is always, always, always charge your charge fist before you start using the grappling hook. So for me, I bound it to my right click button. I always right click first and then use my mouse 4 button, which is like one of the side buttons, and then I launch myself forward. That's how I get the most damage out of the loader. Occasionally, if you have little enemies that are in front of you and like, you know, they're annoying you, then yeah, sure, do like a slight charge. But overall, you should always be charging. Always be charging your charge fist and don't use your grapple hook until after you've charged it fully, because that does greatly impact the amount of damage that you do or do not do as the loader. Yeah, so that was gonna be a ton of damage had we actually landed that on the magma worm. Now you did see me stop right there. Hop up feather is I wouldn't say it's a super important one. It's just more of like a luxury item. If you can get a hop up feather, which allows you, essentially what that does is it allows you to stay on the map if you want to. It allows you to break your momentum if you need to turn up on the dime, but you don't have the extra magazine artifact. And the hop up feather also lets you reposition, which is very nice. We got a whole lot of stuff here. Not exactly sure what the magma worm's at. Looks like it's about halfway dead. Cause a slug? Sure, why not? Yeah, that killed... I know for a fact that killed that wisp. Yeah, that did a lot of damage to that wisp over there. Oh, man. You ever go magma worm wrangling? There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Like, the loader is just pure fun. It is pure fun. It's such a great idea. It's such a great envision to bring the character from Risk of Rain 1 to Risk of Rain 2 in such a delightful but yet stunningly fun way. Like, you wouldn't think that the loader would have translated like this. And what they've done is truly remarkable. And made what I think is one of the most fun characters. It's if the loader isn't the most fun, then she's definitely number two. But to be quite honest, I might be a little bit biased right now just because I've been playing her so much lately. But I do think that she is the most fun. I cannot think of any other class I would rather play right now other than the loader. Now, that being said, I don't think that she's the best class in the game. As I stated earlier, I do think that she is more of a niche need. If you're not playing solo, you know, a group could definitely benefit from a good loader player to take out just heaps and heaps of mobs without really worrying about the survivability. You never have to really worry about a loader player taking out, you don't have to worry about a loader player really jeopardizing your position at all, because their position is always going to be constantly moving. Actually surprised that this magma worm is still alive. It can't be that much more HP here. And oh, punch right through the magma worm. So great. I tell you, one of the most fun things you could do as the loader is when you're fighting the wandering vagrant and then you punch upwards. That's a whole lot of fun. You punch upwards, but like it's a kill shot, like it goes through it. It's so good. It's so satisfying, and I think that's really that's the key word for the loader is satisfying. She's just satisfying to play. The heck? There's a missile drone under there, apparently. I thought I was supposed to donate that to, like, the mushroom or something. I actually got screwed by one of those. There's a note on here somewhere where it said, like, donate one equipment. I don't know what that was for, but I lost one of my very, very important pieces of equipment to that. I think it was the dragon egg, whatever that molten egg is. That thing's really good because it allows you to fly. So I'm hoping that we get that. But honestly, the Royal Capacitor is good enough to keep to the end game anyway. There's the cube, and I don't think we need the primordial cube. Get a secondary healing drone, why not? Grab this chest, and I think that'll be it. We did enact the challenge of the mountains, so this is going to be a little bit interesting. Let's see what's up here real quick. Shoot you down. I don't even feel like dealing with you right now. I've seen enough use of those celestial bronze contraptions where I don't want to see them anymore. Something else that we get Red Whip. I'll go ahead and take that. Even though Red Whip it's hard to utilize that into combat because obviously you only get the movement speed burst whenever you're not in combat. It's still pretty good because at least it can make you move faster and you can set up your attack while still moving from like a from a momentum based standpoint with the red whip. We're just hadoukened our way over there. Go on that Topaz Brooch. Not terrible. Not great. For the loader, anyway. I think the Topaz Brooch is very good, but not one of the most essential ones that you need. So anyway, going back to the loader itself, I have been told that apparently, the skins in the game. This is not something I know for a fact, but apparently the skins in the game can also give you different abilities overall. So like for the loader, for example. Oh my God, there's three of them. For the loader, for example, her grappling hook apparently turns into a spike, and that's pretty cool. Though I haven't gotten that yet. I don't know how to unlock it, but I'll figure it out soon. You can just watch the magma worm HP bar just window as soon as we every time we hit a mark. Oops, accidentally overcharged my ability when I wasn't trying to. Put down a couple of the passer dunks. Always be charging and always be sprinting. Yeah, so we just charge through there. Superman punch our way through. Superwoman punch, I should say. I mean, this is just madness. It's absolute madness with all the three magma worms. We're sitting here trying to wrangle one of them. I think that might have killed one. Hard to tell. Got put right in front of a Elder Lemurian. Do not want to stand in front of him, no matter who you play. Oh yeah, that was a huge hit. I actually cannot believe that they're all still alive. And yes, magma worms still lag out the recording like crazy. CPU does not like magma worms. Oh, it's so good. Grappling hook on one of the magma worms, and then punching through it, so freaking satisfying. And then we killed the other one there. Yeah, it's down to two now. Gonna throw out the lightning pylon just so we can get a couple stacks of the 100 of the headdress. I don't even know what's going on anymore. There's only, I believe, only two. Yeah, now there's only one left. These vultures are definitely annoying. Got another pylon. Predatory instincts should hopefully kick in soon. Basically, anytime I see an Elder Lemurian, I just want to back away from them. We're getting lots and lots of stacks from the Topaz Brooch here. That barrier, the temporary barrier that you're seeing, is not being generated by her passive. Her passive only generates a shield from her basic attacks, which I've already told you that we don't use. It's not that you shouldn't use it. It's just that you don't have to use it. Ooh, and we get two fuel cells. It's going to hold additional charges for the Royal Capacitor as well. That's huge. Being able to spam the Royal Capacitor is pretty amazing, as you saw from the multi-run from a couple months ago. I'm going to finish clearing these guys out just because I think they're a bunch of jerks, and they think they should be punished. So quick turn around there. That's where the hop-up feather is really, really awesome. And I'm not really interested in fighting the overcharged vultures. So good run though so far. I'm liking it. Here we are back on the plains again. Oh man, I love seeing the Elder Wisps, because I just see a target that I can repel off of and just completely wreck. There was a time where you wouldn't want to see the Elder Wisp, the Greater Wisp, but man, oh man. All I see is a disco ball full of fun right there. The Royal Capacitor, the Tweedlebean. Throw out the pylon as well. But this run, I will say this run is pretty light in the damage department. Haven't been really getting all that great of items here. And we're still making it work, is the thing. But the loader is just so much dang fun. I mean, who really cares? So that time I did hold on to the repel. So I am able to get a couple of extra little love taps here on the Tweedlebean, where she makes her royal exit. Sure, why not? Jellyfish, bring it on. Who else wants a piece over here? Who else wants a piece of the champ? Hermit crab, sure. That's not a hermit crab, that's a stone titan. The beam's actually going for, I think, my healing drone. Hey, jerk. So this is the death field, and this is caused by a particular type of champion. I don't remember the name of it. I think they're called like ruined or undead champions. It's something like that. You can't stay in that field for too long without getting real sad real quick. So again, I'm going to charge up my fist, start sprinting, jump up twice, grapple, and then punch. Get flung across the map. Do it again. And this is a really good showing of the value of the Hoppa Feather as well. Being able to faint jump like that while in the air is pretty important, especially for dodging these jerks, the stone golems. And we have another death aura around us, so I want to get out of this as fast as possible. Oh, I just barely missed it. Now, I don't recommend using the grappling hook to pull yourself to dangerous enemies. That's gotten me in trouble a couple of times, particularly speaking with the brass contraptions. They will make you regret doing that. I forgot the Beetle Queen was still alive. Gonna hold on to her, and we're just gonna swing around. That's what's so, again, another fun aspect of the loader is that it doesn't take that long for her charge fist to actually charge up again. So you can truly use it as the main damaging ability without even having to worry about her basic attack. Now, again, that's not to say that you should ignore her basic attack. If you have small enemies around you, then definitely use it, but I don't use it. It's definitely not a primary attack, let's put it that way, in my mind anyway. But I could be wrong. I'm giving you overall observations from my limited experience with the loader. But she is a joy to play. Stay away from the frozen stone titan here. Grab my lunar coin. Now what we really need, if we can get some focus crystals and we can get some crowbars up in here. Up in here. And y'all are gonna really make me lose my mind. Money, check out this equipment cache here. And honestly, I can see the milky chrysalis not being that bad, especially considering of how mobile the loader is, but essentially, you want something more like the Royal Capacitor, or better yet, the Molten Egg. Hey, everybody! Rusted Key is not my idea of a good use of my funds, and that's right. That's why we don't play Chant Shrines right there. Another Topaz Brooch, I'm fine with that. Hey, you turkeys, I need some more gold. You heard the squeaky go off there from the tougher times. That's what I love about it. Anything to mitigate damage. Got another energy drink. Gonna make us move slightly faster, and I appreciate that. I feel like there's been a what seems to be an unusually low amount of chests on this run. Man, I would kill for a backup magazine right now. Oh god. I almost feel guilty doing that. That looks brutal. The physics kind of took a little bit of a wonky ride there because we got wrapped around that stone arch. It's pretty impressive with how all joking aside, it's pretty impressive that how hey, go to it, there we go. It's pretty impressive how the physics actually managed to stay relatively realistic, even when we're talking about a game as crazy as Risk of Rain 2. What I mean by that is like the rappel physics really do kind of obey the laws of what would be considered pseudo realism. They would have punched right through that a death aura mob. All right, I think we've seen enough here. I haven't seen anything that really gets me super excited yet. Of course, we had that behemoth run from our first impressions a couple days ago. Now, if we can get a behemoth on this run, then we're talking there, brother. All right, let's go hit this teleporter and be on our way. Moving pretty fast. More stone titans again. Fine with this. Like they're going for my gunner drone, maybe. I'm being shot by multiple stone titan lasers. Definitely going after my gunner drone, which is kind of a jerk move. Woo, that was a little bit too close for comfort, not gonna lie. I think I'm gonna back out for a second and regen up a little bit. See here, you are able to sprint while charging your fist. That's something that you should always be doing, in my opinion. Punch through two of them. Gotta get out of the way, though. Thank you, Tougher Times, for mitigating a lot of that damage. Back out over here. And this is where, when I had Transcendence, this is really where Transcendence was able to shine whatever I'm out of combat. I don't have to worry about regenning too fast. Or too slow, I mean. It's as soon as I get out of combat, it's like the shields are instantaneous. And that's really the big selling point of Transcendence for the loader. Gonna let my momentum carry us, and again we're just doing drive-by damage, and this is kind of what I was talking about. She doesn't really play like a melee class. As a melee character, you wouldn't be doing this. You'd be standing toe-to-toe, really trying to brawl, at least, or at least be up close and personal, whereas the loader doesn't really do that. You don't want to do that with her, in my opinion, because her greatest asset is going to be her punching through things for tons and tons of damage, moving very, very fast, staying mobile. The more that you're moving, the safer you are with her as well. That's just a general rule in Risk of Rain 2 overall. Thank you, Old War Stealth Kit. Again, showing the value of that item as well. Alright, so it's another Queedle Bean. Big punch to the back of the head. Effort times canceling out some damage there. Again, this is not a great build that we've got. We have a couple of really good things, but overall, this is not an ideal. This is easily one of the weakest loader runs that I've ever had, and we're still doing a pretty respectable job, all things considered, with how far we are into this monsoon run. This is monsoon. We're sitting at 42 minutes, and you know, we're comfortably. Things got a little dicey. I'm not gonna lie, we got a little bit dicey there, but overall, we're staying relatively safe. Punch through the entire world, fling ourselves out. Now there are times like that, what I was just getting ready to say, there are times like that where you gotta be careful about scraping yourself against the ground. But hey, we actually beat that level because we got the bosses down, then we got killed by a blazing stone golem. Either way, I like the loader. I'm gonna do a little bit of research and follow up to see how do you unlock the new skin or whatever it is, the secondary attack, and try out for yourself. Like I said, if you're a newer player, I wouldn't recommend her right now, but if you have her unlocked, then definitely go check her out. She's a lot of fun. Remember, always be charging your charge fist ability. Make sure you're always sprinting, and above all else, make sure you're going for movement speed upgrades. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, or if you are enjoying the Return of Risk Rain 2 content here on the channel, click the like button. Let me know in the comment down below what your favorite artifacts are for the loader herself when you're playing as her. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!